Genius Lab is an outstanding new feature with RIVAGE PM version 6, where a wide range of triggers, conditions, and actions can be created for advanced feature control using macros. In this video, I'm going to show you how to make good use of the user-defined keys as triggers. Each size of RIVAGE PM console has 12 or more physical user-defined keys with different functions layered in 4 banks. Before we proceed, consider the type of function you want to control. Should it have a latching behavior, or should it be unlatched or momentary? Unlatched is simple to program and means the function will only be active while pressing the key down. It can be used for temporary actions and for one-shot actions that don't need to be reversed later. Let's think of a momentary example. How about, I want to press this user-defined key to show specific fader layers on the center and right bays with a specific selected channel, but without affecting the layer on the left bay, because that area is reserved to always show my star channels. So, every time I press that key, it brings a large part of the console surface to a known situation. It's kind of like an advanced home key. Start in the Genius Lab screen by creating a new macro. In the macro list, touch the title and give it a name like CR View. Open the capture area and press the user-defined key you wish to use. Then call up the fader layers you wish to have on top and select the channel you wish to access. You will see the capture table fill up with data. Scroll back to the top. Highlight the user-defined key entry and import it as a trigger. Find the fader bank select entries and import them as actions. Then you'll see a range of captured entries for the selected channel, for the panel and screen on the left, center, and right of the surface. This is due to the cell link options available. So select the appropriate ones for your action, such as the panel on the right and the screen on the center. Next, we'll do a quick edit of the trigger so it acts when the key is pressed rather than released. Touch the trigger item to edit it and change the value from released to pressed. And now it's ready to enable and check. Yes, it works. Though, you may notice in some situations that the selected channel might not always become the expected one due to how the fader layers are changing. So, here's a tip. Disable the macro and edit the action for the selected channel. Add a wait time of 0.5 seconds. That will force the last action to be selecting the channel to overcome the possibility of a new fader layer forcing a change of selected channel, which is actually one of the preferences. Close, enable, and test again. It should be working perfectly now. Perhaps all that we're missing is any indication of what the switch is doing. Well, we don't need a macro to create a static label. We only need to use a macro if we want the state of the label to be changeable. Use the user-defined key screen in the system setup menu to edit the label. What we could easily do though is have the key light up while it is pressed. That can be added to the same macro as an additional action. Disable the macro and add a new action. Select user define as the category. Then select keys as function 1 and LED as function 2. Make sure the correct bank and key number is selected and set the value to on. If you enable the macro and test its behavior now, you will notice that the LED comes on and it stays on. We cannot switch it off, so we need to modify the macro further. Disable the macro again and press the on-screen button for action reverse action. This will allow us to copy all the actions to the reverse action list. We'll do that, though we only need the LED action. So disable the surface select actions. Edit the LED value to be off. Then enable a macro again. Now we can see that the LED comes on as the key is pressed and it goes off again as the key is released. That's perfect. It's working exactly as required. The key is lit up, labeled, and is changing layers. Be sure to watch the next video in this Genius Lab series to see how to program latching behavior with the user-defined keys. See you then.